And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 2. Blind. Quite a mouthful. Let me just check something. I want to make sure I'm not playing on story mode. Okay, so they have this new story time, which is good. We're not playing on that. We're on normal, which I'm pretty sure is where we were from the beginning. For players who are more interested in exploration and story development than the challenge of combat. Tempting, but I'm sure you guys want to see the combat. While story time is active, the enemy composition of battles is the same as normal difficulty, but the game mechanics are biased in the party's favor. Additionally, the party can carry an unlimited number of camping supplies. I really couldn't give a crap about the camping supplies one way or the other. It's kind of a bother to make sure you have them, but eh. I'll keep it like this.
Sure.
And they agree, as I can see. Chancellor Warren himself. And Marshal Foreman. We'll talk to Chancellor Warren. Thank you for coming, Theodas. I've been trying to track you down for some time. Well, you know us. We're always on the move. This is Marshal Foreman, Earl Badamar's military advisor. He will serve as a witness for this proceeding. He gestures to the man next to him. Yes, I see him. Well met, Road Warden. Your reputation precedes you. I admit, you've created a bit of stir throughout the nobility with your reclamation of Caed Nua. Most are still not sure what to think of you. What's this about? The legitimacy of your claim to Caed Nua is in question. Earl Badamar has issued a ruling on the matter. Well, I don't trust him, and I don't want to be that aggressive. Caed Nua was abandoned for over a century, and I've claimed the land through strength of arms. My claim is legitimate. If there were no other claimant, you would be correct. Unfortunately, this is not the case. All will be made clear once Lord Gathbin arrives. Do you have any questions for me while we wait? Who's this other claimant? Well, we can ask just about any other question, then who's the claimant? Or may, I guess Lord Gathbin is the other claimant. Tell me about, what do you know of Gathbin? While I've met him but once, it was ample time to determine the character of Lord Arladur Gathbin, or lack thereof. He is descended from an old Adirin line that predates the War of Defiance. His great-grandfather, Rannig Gathbin, was the Earl of Yenwood during the war. That is, until he was stripped of his lands and driven from the Deerwood. Yenwood? When the Deerwood was a mere colony of Adir, it was divided into 9 earldoms. When the Adirins were defeated and ultimately driven out, 2 of the earldoms were absorbed and borders were adjusted. The Yenwood was one such earldom. The Grasp is now the largest of the 7 earldoms after it consumed the pre-war earldom of Yenwood. Having trouble saying that word, earldom. It encompasses notable settlements such as New Hamar, Gatrin's Grasp, Gilded Vale, and, of course, Caed Nua. I have other questions. Of course. Tell me about Earl Badamar. Earl Badamar comes from an esteemed line of lords that rose to prominence over the war of, after the War of Defiance some 150 years ago. The Deerwood consists of 7 earldoms. The Badamars govern the northern earldom known as the Grasp. As to the current Badamar, he is a fine man, as I know. It is an honor to serve him. Tell me more about the Grasp. The Grasp is now the largest of the 7 earldoms ever... yeah, we've seen that. Do you know which way Earl Badamar has ruled? I am sorry, my lord, I do not. The Earl's decree is settled. What was that about Road Warden? The one who rules Caed Nua on behalf of the Earl of Yenwood is traditionally known as the Road Warden. Your position might not be entirely official, yet, but the title is an appropriate form of address. He nods and smiles. Okay, I don't have any more questions. Your timing is impeccable. Here comes Lord Gathbin now. No, I believe that was a game mechanic, but whichever. Sorry, no, breaking the fourth wall there. An opulently dressed man strides towards the Chancellor, his sandy hair trailing him like a banner caught in a light breeze, boot heels echoing throughout the hall. An elven woman with cropped hair, dressed in dark, glinting mail, shadows his steps before taking position alongside him. She watches you unabashedly, taking your measure. Let's move past this formality as quickly as possible. I've other matters to attend to. It's well known that Caed Nua belongs to me, by right. This was Gathbin saying that. And where is this pretender? She who murdered the Radricks, my own sister, and her husband, and steals my land. Oops. Where is this low-born wretch? Are you blind? I guess you want to know which of us... It would be easier just to say which one of you is... Yeah. So... Okay, so Lord Radrick is the guy's brother-in-law. That's gonna make things awkward. Warren clears his throat and glances at you. This woman here? This is the Lady of Caed Nua? I thought she was just another servant. Perhaps a valet of a scuttering maid. A scullery maid, sorry. Oh god, I like this. I love this. This is awesome. This might not be the wisest thing to choose. And it's probably the complete polar opposite of whatever this aristocrat selection would be if we had skill in that. Yeah, I'm gonna raise my hand. Everyone who owns their own keep, raise a hand. Go on now, don't be shy. Imbecile! Hope you've enjoyed your time squatting on my land. Provoke me further and I'll hang you from the highest wall of Caed Nua when our business is finished. Count Chancellor, read the Earl's decree. Warren breaks the seal on the scroll and unfurls it. We're hoping not going to lose Caed Nua, guys. That would suck. Regarding the matter of the Gathbin claim of Caed Nua, Earl Badamore finds that the Gathbin claim was never relinquished. By law, Caed Nua is the rightful property of the Gathbin family. No, but all that cool stuff is there. I knew it. Gathbin smirks at you, triumphantly. I'm not finished reading, my lord, Chancellor Warren says. Gathbin rolls his eyes and motions for the Chancellor to continue. However, the Earl recognizes Theatus's part in reclaiming Caed Nua, a site that has stood abandoned and even, some would say, cursed, for over a century. Before Caed Nua is returned to the Gathbin family, the Earl has decreed that Lord Gathbin will provide compensation in the form of... Absolutely not. Gathbin folds his arms, a defiant scowl on his face. Hey, you don't know what he's gonna say. For all we know, he could say 10 copper. M'lord? Warren raises his eyebrows. The amount is quite reasonable and a requirement for your land to be returned to you, if you'll just allow me to finish. No. The Earl hasn't been able to enforce his edicts this far south in decades, and now Duke Avar is dead. Earl Badmore's enemies outweigh his allies, it appears. I'll not pay a single copper to this miscreant from my ancestral land. Do you think I'm blind to the Earl's motives, lackey? He thinks he can send a message with this insult. You know, this guy just waits for us to waltz in and fix the place up, get rid of the curse and everything, and now he can just waltz in. No. I mean, the amount of money I put into this place is probably half again that of, you know, the entire, you know, however it took to build it in the first place. Lord Gathbin says, I have a message you can send to that son of a whore. Sheesh. Gathbin raises an open hand as the Chancellor shrinks from him, arms raised in defense. Should we get physical? Punch and grab the arm? Sit by? Grab his arm. Keep your hands off me, you peasant. Gathbin yanks his arm free of your hand and steps back. The elven woman deftly draws a pistol from her thick leather belt. Her eyes widen in anticipation. Warren says, "Milord, milady, please, there's no need for further violence." Lord Gathbin holds your gaze for several heartbeats, his eyes burning with hatred. "I'll be coming for what's mine. Count on it. Come, Captain Emery. We're leaving." Is that the girl with the pistol? Captain Emery? He sneers defiantly before storming down the hall. The captain lowers her pistol and gives a smirking shrug before following her employer. Well, that could have gone better. Chancellor Warren says, "Well, I can't say that Gathbin's reaction was entirely unexpected. Though, through no fault of your own, I'm afraid you've made a powerful enemy." He did seem a little upset, didn't he? I've heard he's always been vicious, even as a boy, and he can hold a grudge for a very long time. In any case, Caed Nua now officially belongs to you since Lord Gathbin has rejected the Earl's decree. He hands you a deep blue scepter, which looks to have been carved entirely out of sapphire. Here, this belonged to one of the old lords of Caed Nua. By right, it's yours now. So we have a Gerd... Howenstennis? Should we send Lord Gathbin 100 copper pieces? Tell him if I catch him or any of his people on my land, they'll be executed. Please extend an invitation to feast with me in the halls of Caed Nua. There's no need for us to be enemies. Let's extend the invitation. I have a feeling sending him 1,000 copper is just going to insult him. Or at the very least, he'll just act insulted. Please extend an invitation to Lord Gathbin to feast with me within the halls of Caed Nua. There's no need for us to be enemies. That is a generous offer, and I'll make sure it reaches Lord Gathbin. It was a pleasure to finally meet you, milady. He bows. Perhaps we'll speak again under more pleasant circumstances. Farewell, Theodis. The marshal nods at you and leaves. Lord Gathbin rejected the Earl of Yenwood's decree, and Caed Nua remains in my possession. Something tells me that Lord Gathbin isn't done with me yet. I should remain on my guard. Yeah, that's what I was planning on doing. Remaining on my guard. Alright. Now, is it tab reveals items? Yeah. Of course, that's stealing. So I'm not going to mess around with that. Well, that was certainly interesting. I can't believe the mob left this place in one piece. With Duke Eivor gone, we've got our work cut out for us. I just want to see what party members there were. Horavius will be back in a few days. All this stuff should be completed. It's uncomplete. This kept happening to me during the playthrough. I was basically paying money and then things were becoming uncompleted again. Unless these things require upkeep on a general basis. Alright, we're gonna want it as protected. So, the text was right in the dream. It was only partially, partially fixed up. I can't think of the term. Anyway, we need to get the hell out of here and get to the White March. Yeah. There's one thing that we need. I don't know where... I'll try Copper Lane. We do need some healing items. Some healing potions and such. It's just been so long since I've been here. I believe we can buy items at the Goose and Fox. Maybe the marketplace. Possibly. I mean, you'd think duh, but I think there might just be weapons and armor there. I think they're getting lost or something. Well, they were.
Welcome!
I'm glad the fighting is finally over. Had to replace my cart, but I'm just lucky to be alive. Need any scrolls or enchanted garb? Fortunately, I managed to save most of my goods. That's this knife for the boy that I don't want to do. Well, we got scrolls, we got rings. Oh, good. Potion of Major Endurance. Ashwood cameo figurine. Anyway, yeah. All of those. Regen. Major recovery. I guess we emptied this out. Unless I lost the contents of it and putting my game in. The whole game, what happened, guys, is that the game, my Pillars of Eternity and the White March were on a disc that failed on me. So luckily my saves were still, you know, on my system disc. Oh, okay, here we have stuff. We have lots of stuff. Minor Endurance. Minor recovery. We have any of these. Wizard's double. Minor regeneration. The minor stuff isn't that helpful to us right now. Being as we're up in levels and hit points and such. Major recovery. So, okay, so we don't need that, any of that. Yeah. We need regen and endurance. And all right. I want to see if we can get some more.
Good day to you.
Glad the fighting finally stopped. I couldn't imagine what the fuss was about when I heard the racket coming from first fires, but I'm thankful I ran. He dusts his hand on his tunic, looking to buy rations. No, I want potions. And we're already full of camping supplies, so we don't need anything from this guy. I forget, do these guys sell things? Oh. We've read this crap already. Seems like every 200 years someone tries to burn this city down. At least I won't be around the next time it happens.
Hello!
Hello! Do we have lockpicks? Do we need lockpicks? I'm pretty sure we sometimes do. Let's get lockpicks. These are things I might use at some point. Miscellaneous items. We do have pry bars. We have 159 lockpicks. No, I don't think we need any more lockpicks. Hello again, the Orland woman says in a familiar tone. Thanks for visiting my store. I'm still trying to recover from losing that cargo, she says with a huff. My inventory isn't what it used to be, but hopefully I've got something you'll like. I hope so too, but you only have traps, rope and grapple. Do we have rope and grappling hooks? I have to make sure we have this crap, guys. Sorry. We sometimes use those during dialogues, and I don't suppose we can stack torches. Oh, it looks like that when you pick it up. No, we can't stack torches. Not that it matters. That this stash is... You have unlimited pages of crap, but we have two. Someone will have one on them. I think we need one at a stash or something to use it. Come with us, Skull. And the final place I want to go is... I think here? Hireling Payday. Yes. The Goose and Fox. He might sell some things in here. And then we'll be on our way. To be prepared and all that.
Greetings.
Greetings, my good man. Refreshments. These don't look very refreshing. Oh my god, how many clubs and bows could someone have? Do we have a hammer? I'm forgetting about all this crap. Hammer and chisel, we have two. Yeah, we'll take one. Yes, you can buy a dog. We're not going to. Yeah, I'm not seeing potions. Well, we're gonna have to make do with what we have. That's not what I meant to hit. How do I get into...
Sure.
Inventory. I, right? Okay. Little things like that, forgetting. So, shift, I believe? No, wait. Did that put in... that put in the stash, didn't it? Wait, these are potions. It did. Alright, if I double click, yes, then okay. That's what I wanted to do. One for a dare. I still haven't figured out what to do with all these grimoires. I want to, like, consolidate them or something. Endurance, endurance. The regen can go for a dare. He has a lot of hit points. Excuse me. Oh. Okay. I'd prefer a lot more than that, but we'll have to see if we can buy more. And off we go. Interestingly enough, this episode, well, the previous episode, let's move up here. I think we have to go to Stalwart. I'm going to choose standard. A dear and noble one left. No one hired her. How sad. Alright, where are we supposed to be going here? I'm not even completely sure I'm supposed to be going to Stalwart. Seek information. Alright, yep, we're in Stalwart. Oh, wait.
While we wait, the enemy grows stronger.
Okay.
And you'd send more of us to die! Well, I'm not gonna stand around. Are you?
You've done plenty, Darian!
Oops. You approach the source of the commotion and see a throng of villagers. They're arguing amongst themselves and hurling questions and demands at a lone figure perched above them. Yeah, it's like he's on a stage or something of his own design. A young man stands on a spur of rock, his clenched fist held aloft. Steam rises from his wild hair and flushed face as he shouts to the gathering.
Been a week since our people left these gates. A week since the Iron Flail took him.
He paces the outcropping, his eyes burning. You see a few scattered nods in the crowd.
Yet we wait here behind our sturdy new walls, hiding in our rebuilt homes. We've done nothing.
He brings his fist into his palm with a sharp smack. The crowd erupts, bristling with pointed fingers and pointed words. One woman steps forward, her eyes lock on the young man.
Who are you to tell us how to defend our own? You ain't been here 2 months!
Several of the others grunt and hoot. You feel a shift in the crowd like a changing tide.
Hey, an angry mob! See? We're not so far from home.
I love it there.
And since I got here, I've been working alongside the rest of you. Don't start with that again.
A handful of others nod along with him, but they cringe and flinch as another villager joins the fray, shaking his finger at the young orator.
Well, it was your idea to send our people to that damned fort in the first place. If it weren't for you and the other leeches that come up with you, we wouldn't be in this mess.
The new accuser raises a chorus of furious cries. Darian raises his hands for calm, but the crowd's wrath is snowballing. I probably should stop them, but I want to continue listening at least for one time. If I get another chance, I'll stop everything.
Enough. Enough!
Darian waves for calm, but the crowd has worked itself into a frenzy. He scans the assembly, beads of sweat rolling from his temples. His eyes fall on you, and he points. Uh-oh. Regan accuses us of something.
You want to boot all the outlanders from your town? Tell that to the hero of the White Forge.
Who, me? I just got here.
Hey, it wasn't just me. This watcher deserves at least a little credit.
No one seems to notice a dare. A dozen heads turn in your direction. The villagers' curiosity turns to fury as they recognize you. Enough shouting. I want someone to calmly explain what's going on. Darian nods.
It's a small army from Raid Saris. They call themselves the Iron Flail.
At Darian's mention of the name, the rest of the crowd falls silent. The words trigger a sudden flashback to your dream of the mysterious army and the destruction of Caed Nua. As the image fades, you see once more the vision of 100 eyes watching you and something just beyond.
Showed up a few weeks after you opened the battery. Demanded we give him the White Forge.
He avoids your gaze, scraping his boot against a rock.
They're led by a Darik Sendamir. Comes from an old Raid Saren family. Rumor has it the man's half mad with visions. Claims one drove him here to take the White Forge.
They're not the only bloodsuckers around here.
The villager glares up at Darian, but most of his fellows are ignoring him by now. Darian raises his voice above the ruckus. So, could he be describing another watcher?
Our crew at the battery locked their doors and told the Iron Flail to go back to Raid Saris. Instead, they built a fort in the middle of the wood. So we sent a committee to reason with them. That was a week ago. We haven't seen our people since.
A low rumble ripples through the crowd. Darian hesitates, and somehow we gain experience.
That can only mean one thing.
He grimaces as the frightened, arguing crowd drowns him out once more. Hmm. Tough choice. I don't think these people are prepared to share anything. I'm afraid that even mentioning it will send them into a frenzy. I'd prefer to get more information about these other people. Well, it is a question. It's not a statement. Can't you share the White Forge with the Red Sarens? I know this isn't going to go over well. The villagers shout and squawk louder than ever. Yep.
After what they did to our neighbors?
Only thing they know how to do is start wars!
Maybe we could nudge them into torching their own village.
Nice.
Please, everyone!
In the fragile silence that follows, the others turn and look at Darien. Well, he has their attention again.
Whatever our differences, we've got to deal with the army at our gates!
He looks back to you.
You may be the only person around here who's more unpopular than I am, but if anyone could get into that fort and deal with an army, it's you.
Just show me where this fort is.
The Iron Flail cleared a patch of forest north of Durgan's Battery. Built their fort there.
North of Durgan's Battery.
It'll be well guarded, so if you can get in without raising an alarm, you may have an easier time of it.
Not completely sure I'll be successful with that, but we'll give it a try.
The important thing is to deal with the commander. If you can get rid of him, the rest of the soldiers will scatter.
I think I've dreamed about this army.
What exactly did you see?
He watches you with wide, wondering eyes. A murmur ripples through the crowd. This crowd is kind of frenzied. I don't want to tell them Stalwart was destroyed. Neither do I really think I should lie. The dream was unclear. Then what was my purpose in just saying I had a dream about them? I think this is our best option, either this or this. The dream was unclear.
Of course. We're just thankful this dream led you back.
Oh, you're thankful now.
Anyway, we've got our work cut out for us here.
He gives the crowd a purposeful look. Grumbling, they start to disperse.
While you're out, stop by the battery. Wangra and her team are still repairing the heavy cannons, but they've made a lot of progress elsewhere.
Okay.
Thought you might like to see how far it's come.
He shrugs. I wanted to ask you about something.
Haven't been here long, but I'll tell you what I can.
Tell me about the Iron Flail.
They heard about the White Forge and came running. Just like a lot of us did. Only difference is, they brought siege weapons. As best anyone can tell, they're from the border region near Little Bend, one of the poorest parts of the country. For Raid Saris, well, that's saying something.
There seems to be a lot of tension around town.
Before you open Durgan's Battery, people tell me Stalwart barely had enough warm bodies to keep the town running. A bunch of us came when we heard about the White Forge. But now, I think the old-timers would just as soon send us back.
He begins ticking items off on his fingers.
We take the best jobs, we don't pay our respects to Andra, we're overcrowding the town.
He shakes his head.
I get it. Stalwart's changing. Same thing happened in New Yarma when folk moved in from the countryside. But they can't keep blaming us for everything that goes wrong out here.
He sighs, and a steaming cloud escapes his lips.
I'm just hoping they'll calm down once the Iron Flail is gone.
Yeah. So what brought you to Stalwart?
Work. I was a cobbler in New Yarma, but the city got more crowded every year. Rural types fleeing the legacy. A couple months ago, I heard Stalwart was offering land and opportunity to new settlers, so figured I'd give it a go out here. For a while, folks seemed glad to have some new blood. But that changed as more and more of us came.
Well, that's all. The fort has been built to the east of Stalwart, and it may house the army I seek. The fort was built by Red Sarans with an interest in capturing Durgan's battery. Stalwart sent a group of delegates from among their residents to try and parley with the Red Sarans, but their delegates never returned. Iron Flail. The villagers of Stalwart are concerned about a band of Red Sarans known as the Iron Flail, which has come to the mountain with the intention of claiming the battery for themselves. The delegate part, the Iron Flail has erected a fort in the mountain pass to the northwest. Any answers as to the fate of the Stalwart delegates will lie there. Darian asked me to deal with their commander, Adaric Sendemir. If I'm saying that right. Ready for the cannons? The heavy cannons at the top of the west tower of Durgan's battery were once a powerful defense. They could be a valuable safeguard for the battery and me. Darian mentioned that Wengra and her crew are repairing the battery's heavy cannons. It would be worthwhile to check on them. These cannons could be a formidable weapon against the army from my vision. Anything else? No. Cool. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time when we walk around Stalwart and see what the various people have to say. I'm sure there'll be some new lines thrown here and there at the very least. Hopefully we can pick up some more information about what happened. Some details and such. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.